Can you forgive me about your presence when you connect with me?
Sure. When I was pregnant on the third month, everything was going well. But by the 14th week of pregnancy, I started having pain and bleeding. I went to the doctor, and the doctor says that is a sign that you're probably going to lose this baby. If you want to make sure you have a chance to keep the baby, you need to rest a lot and stay out of your feet. So I did that for a few weeks. And then everything became more normal. About, 5 months, everything went better. When you were born, everything was fine. Have a normal delivery, and we took you
home.
I
cut the cord.
Yeah. And as far as we knew, we had a beautiful, normal baby. Take you home. Happy. Well, we noticed that, I noticed that even if we make a lot of noise, the baby will continue to sleep. So, what a nice baby to sleep through noise and slamming doors from Kimberly Lindsay. So we thought it was nice, happy, normal baby. What happened after that? When you were about 5 months old, I took you to get vaccines, shots. And then the nurse said, this baby should be able to sit up straight. And she's not sitting normal. Something's not right. I said, well, I know that I always have to hold your little head because we're not very firm, very soft, so I will always hold you like this, even when you were 4, 5 months, 6 months. Always have to hold you like this, so your head will not go everywhere. And we noticed you didn't grow, but we thought maybe she's just a little slow.
Yeah, but maybe the development was just a little bit behind.
Yeah, so we didn't think anything wrong. But, not crawling, not turning. We saw maybe just a little slow, but nothing wrong.
And you were always happy. Happy, happy, happy baby.
Yeah. When the nurse said there's something wrong with the baby, then I asked the doctor, can you check my baby very good? And the doctor said, that was the same doctor that has seen you since birth, and Kimberly Lindsay, same doctor. The doctor said, this baby is normal, normal. There's nothing wrong with this baby. You know, she's not sitting down, she's not crawling, she's just a little slow, but she's perfectly fine. And I said, well, can you test her hearing? Maybe. Just check her. I asked her, can you check everything in the baby? Then the doctor make a lot of noise and you didn't respond. So then the doctor said, we need to go and send her to children's hospital and get some testing. And you were about 6 months old. Mm-hmm. Well, we took you to Children's Hospital. They did a lot of testing, and they said that there was something wrong with your hearing. You couldn't hear, and there was something wrong with your, they said you had cerebral palsy.
Yeah. Light cerebral palsy.
Mm-hmm.
CP?
Yeah. Yeah. So we asked the doctor, what does that mean? And then the doctor said, but she may never be the same as your other two girls. She may never be able to walk. She may never be able to sit up nicely and play like other children. Right? Remember that?
Mm-hmm.
And so we went home very sad. You can't hear.
They did some tests like all day at the hospital with tests, and of course we were just walking
more than one day
and praying
many days
and waiting, and then later they told us that your cochlea was not developed fully
at birth. Uh-huh. So that is the inner ear was not developed. And so they show us the picture of what an inner ear should look like, and they told us yours was not complete. So there was something wrong when you were in my mom's tummy. So we went home and began to pray. And continued to pray. Then very, very soon After that, you started crawling. Then very soon after that, you started going up the stairs and coming down the stairs. And very soon after that, you went outside and play and go down the slide and the swing. Mm-hmm. And very much normal, except that you couldn't hear. So we continue to trust God to complete what He began, a miracle. Because it is a miracle that you are normal, and that you were very involved in sports, playing basketball,
volleyball,
skiing.
We didn't know anything about the deaf community, didn't know anything about sign language, didn't know anything. And the people from Children's Hospital, you know, told us about an organization that would help us learn about, you know, services available to help you. So you started to go to classes when you were about 3 years old?
No. As soon as we found out that you couldn't hear, then at first it was very, very, very hard. You didn't want to accept that it's real. Then you accept that and said, God, we're trusting you for a miracle, but I need to be able to communicate with her. So immediately, quit. I started taking lessons at Southwestern College. Then I went to Mesa College for like 2 years.
Right.
Mm-hmm. 2 years.
I was talking about we sent Ashley to school at 3 years old for some classes?
I think she was four.
Four?
Four, yeah. 4 years old. Learning sign language was not hard. It was hard when the teacher will go from signing to finger spelling. Then I will get lost. And then that was a very bad experience because the teacher was not very merciful. So I made it through.
And later I went to adult school in the night and took some sign lessons. But really, you have been my best teacher.
Yep.
I thought I would. But if the death should happen,
well, they suggest that you will start going to school right away, like 2 years old, and we say no, because we feel that being at home was more important for you than being at school with other kids. So you start going to school when you were 4.
The people that the Children's Hospital told us about the school for deaf kids and to help us.
Yeah, so when we found out that you couldn't hear, then very quick after that, we started speech for you when you were like 9 months old. So I will drive 2 or 3 times a week to Children's Hospital, and they'll do speech for you. So I'll sit down with a lady and sit down, and they'll teach you words. First words you learned was mom and dad. You were like 10 months old, 10, 1 year old, yeah. It's that early at Children's Hospital. Remember, I used to drive all the way there for her to sit down. And so they started teaching you words like mom, dad.
Sign language words though, hon, right?
Yes.
Yes.
But it was also speech.
Right.
But 10 months old. 10 months old, they started teaching you how to sign. So I learned. So mom, dad, sister, cookie. You learned that word very good, cookie. Yes, they told us about the deaf.
We knew you needed the help from a deaf school and didn't have a problem having you go to Vista Square Elementary, and you went for like preschool there, and that was, you know, you needed to have So we had you go to Vista Square Elementary for preschool, and that was helping. You were learning and we were learning, mom more than me, because she was taking classes. And as you continue to grow, and you know, first, second, third, what grade when she started to mainstream? It
was like third.
Yeah.
Third or second.
Second or third grade.
I think it was second.
Which?
Second grade.
In kindergarten, you had some. At first, when they would mainstream. Right, right.
Yeah, 1 or 2 classes, right. Yeah.
Oh, that's how.
Right.
Save us to
Deathpool. Oh, Deathpool.
Yeah. When you were in, like, maybe junior high, or maybe fifth grade, you know, like, old enough to have your own opinion about things, you wanted us to send you to a live-in school for deaf kids in Riverside. And you cried because mom and dad said, no, don't want to send you away to school. And so we thought it was more important to have our input in your life more than the language you would get from full-time deaf school. You were not happy about that.
Fair hard for me. Fair, dad.
You're glad you didn't go good. We're good because we feel that family is very, very important. And when children leave home young, they still need parents more than classmates, we think.
Yeah.
So I'm glad you feel that way now, because we really love you.
Yeah.
Hi, Beth.
We felt strongly that it was our responsibility to raise you, not school.
Hi, okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you were mainstreamed. Then when it came time for junior high, you changed schools, remember? And went to a campus where there was no other deaf kids there. Was Stephania there at first, or no? Stephania?
Yes, Stephania was there.
Was there?
Yeah, there. In half room.
Oh, so not at in middle school alone.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, middle school.
Back to the
know that the journey has not always been easy, but we can do all things through Christ who gives us strength, and we will never trade you for another girl. And if they put 1 billion girls in front of us, we will always be cute because we love you.
Raising you was not that different than raising your sisters. We needed to love you lots and lots and lots, and the communication was the more hard part, but you always were affectionate girl, and we just love you, love you, love you a lot, and God help us.
And you were also very, very patient with us, because we don't know how to sign perfectly, but we can understand each other.
But haven't got
right, but
Tipper. Remember that man.
Right.
Yeah, I bet her.
Raising a dead child, seeing your child not being able to hear, and you wishing you can trade places with that child.
Same as what Mom said, but you know, we see you the same as your sisters.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And you had your moments, same as all kids do, you know, do mischievous things, but has nothing to do with deafness. So we raise you the same. You know, communication a little more difficult, yes, but
not always, because we did feel we always treated you the same as the other two girls.
Right.
But you asked me what was hard about it. I wanted you to hear and not miss anything, but I know I needed to treat you the same and always feel proud and thankful to God for you.
we try to always give you the same opportunities your sisters had.
Piano.
You know, yeah, she took piano lessons.
Then became very bored at it, so we stopped.
Yeah. played sports and did very good. Mm-hmm. Probably the best of the three girls.
Yeah.
But you had a good raising up.
Good. Then so hard and big.
I know that sometimes, especially in high school, when you were in public school and your sisters had gone to Christian high school, that you always had extra eyes on you because of the interpreters, and like having a second mom always there to tell you and correct you, you know, made it a little more hard. But mom and dad always wanted to have you mainstreamed because you needed to learn to live in a hearing world. And then later when you changed schools, we got some help to get more services from the school district, mm-hmm. because your speech after fifth grade was very limited. And after we got more help from the school district, your speech started to improve. And then your mom has continued to work on that. And I think that's a good thing because it helps you with communication with me and mom and other people too.
Mm-hmm. But you have this part of none or done.
If anything, I think we would have wanted to press to get more speech more early, because there was no reason why you shouldn't have had that opportunity earlier than seventh grade.
But
I think, you know, find out what services are available. Sometimes you maybe need to get a consultant and find out what your rights are, because the school don't always tell you what your rights are. But communication is very, very, very important. And find out what your rights are, and then be proactive to enforce them for the benefit of your child.
I think the same way. Be very, very involved in your child's life. You know, learning sign, spend time.
That's a big one.
And make him feel that he or she is very important because they are very important and they're very valuable to you.
I'm gonna say that back.